And now comes to the name we are waiting for. Om Chinmayāya Namaha.
Om Chinmayāya Namaha.
Om Chinmayāya Namaha.
Om
Chinmayāya Namaha. Om Chinmayāya Namaha. And we know Gurudev by the name Swami Chinmayananda. Sannyasis are given all names of or indicators or the names of the Atma, of the Supreme Self of the reality. So it is not any individual name or individual quality. Whether it is Sachidananda, whether it is Swarupananda, whether it is Chidananda, whether it is Chinmayananda, whether it is Shivananda, these are all names of truth or reality. And what must have Swami Shivananda foreseen? All of you are always curious, but you are not going to take. When Pujya Gurudev went with all his inquiries to Swami Shivananda, and he was quite a revolt, because he was not an atheist, but he would not accept anything blindly. He had plenty of questions and he wanted answers and he wanted convincing answers. I didn't think that these street sadhu babas or these priests could answer. They only said, believe, believe, believe. In any religion of the world also, just believe, believe, believe. But having come to a teacher like Swami Shivananda and admiring that this is not one of those sadhus that are just sitting there and smoking a hookah or something, but so selflessly serving the people, besides his own meditation, besides his spiritual discourses, he got so inspired. And even though he said Gurudev would walk with his shoes sometimes inside, sometimes he was all wearing his clothes, and people in the ashram used to get very, you know, there's certain decorum, no? Some of you also do it, and somebody says, shh, you can't do it like that. Move, 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 move. There's certain decorum in the ashram that you have to follow. But he used to. He used to even walk in sometimes the kitchen, because he sometimes could cook also. So he would walk into the kitchen. He used to do such hilarious play for Swami Shivananda. In one of them, he even became a girl. And Swami Shivananda used to laugh. I mean, he used to do some, even, you know, things there. And people sometimes used to get a little bit irritated with, like, how can he get away with this? How come Swami Shivananda even tolerate him? But not that he was irreverential, but Swami Shivananda would answer every question of this inquiring young man. But he had once told us that finally when he went, because he had gone to the Himalayas to expose these sadhus, and he realized that there are such sadhus also roaming around, wasting away their life, and there were sadhus like Swami Shivananda, and he wanted to show this whole bluff about many of these holy men. So he wrote the article for which he had gone there, but he went to Swami Shivananda and he said, should I print this? You know, journalist also must have sense of responsibility. Should I print this article? Because it's not like every sadhu is like this. So Swami Shivananda said, you've written, go print. He didn't say, no, no, you shouldn't do this. He said, go print. Then he said, I've understood the logic of religion. I've understood the logic of spiritual life. I've understood this. Now I see the importance of it. But I don't understand, why should one renounce and become a sannyasi? And he told us that Swami Shivananda, who used to answer every question of mine, that also is the starting which I asked as though defying or even argumentatively. He said, I'm not going to answer this question. So immediately, for the first time, he's been told no. So he said, why? He said, it's not a sincere question. He said, but I'm asking sincerely, I really want to know. He said, if I tell you the importance of sannyas, will you become a sannyasi? Will you become a sannyasi? Who? Gurudev said, I had to first go, sit on the banks of the Ganga, cool myself down. But when the quest is there, he went to Swami Shivananda, and whatever Swami Shivananda told him, he decided to take up sannyas, the path of renunciation. Required a lot of courage for a person whose everything is going on in his life. He's getting promotions, he's in the elite society of Delhi. His profession. And just when everything was going smoothly, India has gained its independence. His journalism is being appreciated. All this, at that is the time he went up to him and said, yes, if you can convince me, I will. And whatever Swami Shivananda said, he was convinced. And he was daring enough to take to the path. Now when you take sannyas, later on it will come, sannyasi ne namaha. We may not reach those portions, but I'm explaining all these words that later on you can see and you can understand the meaning of it. Who is a sannyasi? In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna points out. Sannyasi is not one who has given up all work and sits back doing nothing, sitting on the rock and becoming a rock and only going and eating by begging food. Nyeyam sanitya sannyasi. Yona rishyati na kangshati. One who is free of all desires, with the knowledge that the Atma is infinite and permanent, and in the finite, impermanent world, there can be no permanent happiness. Such a person is a sannyasi. Not only who has given up, as you say, renounced the pleasures of the world, but even the desire for it. And one cannot give up need, desire, until and unless one has renounce this identification with the body, mind, and intellect. Whether you walk the path of sannyas, the goal is that. And who is a sannyasi? One who has renounced his own thought. Means renounced his own mind. One who is gunatita. Such a person has got no ego, no identity. Therefore, when you go and drop your old clothes, and this body is also called as clothes in the Bhagavad Gita, really speaking, no body identification, and typically a sannyasi has no clothes on his body. not even orange, yellow. Because no body, no home, aniketa, later on dehatita, beyond the body, gunatita, without any mind, and therefore without any ego. And where there is no ego, there is no identity, there is no form, and therefore no name also. So really speaking, a sannyasi is anami, aniketa, naishkarmya, who has got no ego in activity. Thus, really speaking, there is no name also. And Gurudev used to laugh. But you know, when they have to walk in public, the public will be embarrassed, so they are given clothes. So, the Guru gives back, like Krishna gave back to the gopis the clothes. That now this body is my body. The matter vestcha. And gives a name so that people will recognize that person. So even if a form is given, then the name also has to be there. Now all are names of the Atma only, which indicate the self, which is the self of each one. Like I told you that day, everybody is Ananda Swarupa only. Everybody is of the nature of consciousness. He gave different names to different disciples. What must he have thought to give him the word name Chinmaya? Chinmaya, don't think Chin means Chin. Maya means Chinmaya, full of Chin, 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 Chin. Must be Chinese, Chin, Chin, Chu. Actually in Sanskrit, Chitmaya. If you keep on saying Chitmaya, Chinmaya, Chin, it becomes Chinmaya. So it actually means Chitmaya. Chit means consciousness. Maya means pervaded by, full of consciousness, awareness. Chit is the consciousness which is knowledge absolute. And therefore, Chinmaya means one who is full of the absolute knowledge, or full with absolute knowledge, or one who is fulfilled in knowledge, one who has recognized I am consciousness. And Ananda is of course added, because that consciousness is bliss. So one who is conscious of his blissful nature, such a person of knowledge, fully attentive to gain knowledge, fully attentive in his knowledge, established in his knowledge, is called as Chinmaya. And even today, amongst all the saints and sages, the one who is full of knowledge and who could give the knowledge like the way he gave is only Chinmaya. So therefore, Chinmaya. Very embodiment of awareness, very embodiment of knowledge. Knowledge was just flowing from every breath of him. I'm telling you, sometimes people used to go with such questions, even there he would reveal the truth to them. Some I will not share with you right now. How he could reveal the knowledge in everything. Also, Chinmaya means one who is self-aware, who's attentive, aware all the time. That is called as Chinmaya. But I tell you, I found out a fantastic definition of Chinmaya. And and it definitely suits Gurudev, okay? Whenever anybody, being a teacher of Vedanta, Sarvam Khaluvidam Brahma, all this is Brahman, you are Brahman, I am Brahman, yeah? He never shows his superiority over anybody. In fact, I just found one letter. This person wrote that this person who teaches the Upanishads writes that you talk about meditation and that is not pure Vedanta. I'm confused because I listened to you, I listened to him, I have reverence for both the teachers. But he said like this, now my reverence for him is gone. But at the same time, I have a doubt, are you teaching the right thing? What a letter Gurudev writes. He says he's probably writing from his standpoint of realization that really speaking, a realized master does not require meditation. But the scriptures are very clear that you need to meditate. See, what humility, what greatness, what clarity of knowledge. For him, everybody was Brahman. He says, maybe from his state of realization, he says like that. Obviously, I don't think so, that person was realized. Okay, that's my opinion, and he wouldn't like it. Obviously, he doesn't know what he's talking about. But maybe from his standpoint, that also, you see our knowledge? Realized master doesn't require meditation. But a seeker does require. The Upanishads themselves say it. Shraddha, bhakti, dhyana, yogad, avaihi. Come to know it with meditation. The meditation is not the means for knowledge, but it's meant to be attentive to gain the knowledge from the teacher. So if you propagate meditation in that way, I mean, you don't have to know all that. I'm just telling you. And therefore, if anybody came and told Gurudev, you are God, he said, you are also God. Only you don't know it, Buddhu. That's all. You purify your boo, remove the boo, the world and the mud, you know, the earth from your mind. You are the. You are the Brahman. So there are people, you know, used to go up to Gurudev and ask him, no? That are you an... So I remember this. There was this chick from Chennai. And this chick from Chennai even till today. No? He had come. And Gurudev would allow any type of questions. So what when we are walking him from his kutia, from the dining hall to his kutia, that's the time we used to spend so much time. So all the youngsters started coming in, they would join us in. So one day he says, Gurudev, they say that Swami Vivekananda is the avatar of the Sept Rishis. You know, so-and-so is the avatar of so-and-so, so-and-so is the avatar, like Dattatreya is the avatar of Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. You know, like that, all these great gurus, teachers are avatars of someone. So Gurudev said, yes, that's how people believe. But why do you want to call someone as an avatar? Everyone is Brahman only. Why don't we see Vivekananda as Vivekananda? No? Why do you have to say that he's avatar of someone? No? Like that he was explaining. After all, you are also avatar, you don't know. One who knows his divine nature is an avatar, like that, you know. Now, definition of avatar is not, you know, is a manifestation. So why do you have to say so and so is an avatar? Everybody is Brahman only. He who realizes it is Brahman. Now, this boy was hitting around somewhere else. Now, Gurudev explained that, now keep quiet, no? But no, after saying that they say this avatar, and Gurudev said, everyone wants to believe that so-and-so is avatar of so-and-so, so-and-so, there is only one Lord, everybody is avatar of that only. Avatar knows it, you don't know it, that's all. No? Like that. Then, he came. I also gathered. You think Gurudev didn't gather what he's coming to? I also gathered. I said, oh, no. He's going to get a scolding right now. After so much explanation, he said, Swamiji, Swamiji, whose avatar you are? After having explained all this, whose avatar you are? And he said, Are Baba, you are also an avatar. You have to just know it. You know, avatar means God only is manifested in all these forms. Explained all these things, but he wouldn't understand. Whose avatar you are, Swamiji? Whose avatar you are? And it's true, you know. When you saw his majesty, when you saw him, you know, his uprightness and his, you know, righteousness and his, you know, real royalty, you know. Even if he just wore one piece of cotton cloth on himself, he was so royal. He looked like Ramchandraji walking. Literally, you could feel as though Ramchandraji, when he walked, how majestically, you could see him as Ramchandraji. When he sat there in meditation with his flowing hair, you know, and with that compassion in his eyes and that serenity, you could literally see Lord Shiva. Or even if you are indisciplined, you know, Anushasana Priyaya Namaha, you could see the wrath of Lord Shiva at that time, you know. And the compassion of Lord Shiva. So sometimes, you know, when he walked with his flowing hair, he was like, you know, so majestic, so mighty like Lord Shiva. And in his mischiefs and his laughter, when he laughed and he made you laugh, and his mischief and his humor, and in every situation of life to be happy and make everybody happy, he was like Krishna. You could just see like Krishna is fooling around, you know. So it is not that you could not see any of this manifestation. It's not about believing in something. So why you have to ask? Of course he is. And you have to see your guru only as a manifestation of the Lord. But no, who's avatar? You know, again, that everybody wants to still find some individuality. You know? So some individual God took avatar. You know? And Gurudev did not answer. And when he used to reach his kutia, we could not cross his parapet. Because he had to go and rest. So, stood there, and just besides his kutia is the towering form of Hanumanji, the picture that you see everywhere. So he pestered, and I'm saying this guy is going to be blown off. Now he's going to see Shiva manifest. And you could see that Gurudev was getting a little bit irritated. But he was asking, like a child was asking, Gurudev, Gurudev, please say, no, please, please say, whose avatar you are? Please say, you're Ramchandra's avatar, or you're Krishna's avatar, or you're Shiva's avatar. And Gurudev looks at Hanuman and says, I'm his avatar. And says, I am like him, the connection between you and Ram. He was so thrilled, at least Gurudev gave him an answer. But I thought, you know, those who are there, okay, you know, true, Guru is the connection like Hanumanji between this and that, like that, you know. One trip, I was with Gurudev, and this lady, who has taken all Gurudev's pictures, and because of her, today we've got all these pictures. And I tell you, she's a riot. And some of these girls have been like that because they've grown up with Gurudev from childhood. So they have this audacity to say anything and everything. And we would be sitting there getting shocked. How can you speak? But I tell you, being a girl, you get away with murder sometimes. I remember even those chick friends of mine who have grown up, you know, as children, literally, or little teenagers, they could go up to Gurudev. And I remember I'm sitting on the flight with Gurudev first time. And this chick is with Gurudev sitting there. I'm sitting there. And she tells Gurudev, 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 your beard appears so soft, soft like candy floss. And I'm on the aisle on the other side. I'm listening to this conversation. I mean, how can you speak to Gurudev like that, you know? And thanks to her only really speaking, that, and she would say, He's got a question. He's afraid to come and talk to you. And oh God. All said and done that I could go and open up and talk to Gurudev. I must say it's because of her, but I would never have the audacity to speak like this, you know. I'm listening to this conversation and she says, may I touch your beard? Just feel your beard. She's like a child in front of Gurudev. May I touch your beard? And he says, no, it's all going on the flight. No. No. And she said, please, please. Now, can you imagine? A guy said, please, please, please. I tell you, that's the only time I felt that it's really nice to be a girl devotee, you know. Please, please, please. I said, no, no, no. So she says, well, please, Swamiji, please. I said, no. And I was like, thank God, this is embarrassing. But she sat there, please, no, please, please. And suddenly, after some time, she said, okay. Yeah. And she touches. Of course, you and I asked, how was it? How was it? And she says, you can't imagine, his beard is so smooth, it's even smoother than candy floss. I said, thank God you didn't say, may I eat it? But this was the other lady, she was in her 50s at that time, but she also, you know, and she also had the audacity of to say something. Now we are sitting there, she's sitting on the ground taking Gurudev's photographs, she's clicking away, and we are sitting there, and then she says, since you're a photographer, she says, I've seen Gurudev's, your photographs when you were young. You were so handsome. And that's true, you look at Gurudev's, you see this one behind, no, like, and some of them, he's sitting there in meditation. Oh, he's so majestic, he's so handsome. She says, you're so handsome. Swamiji, we have never seen you without a beard. Sometimes, Swamiji, you must shave your beard. We want to see, even now you must be looking so handsome. She's telling to Gurudev. I mean, Gurudev, when he was at the platform, he was such a roaring master that you just sat in awe of him. And this is the conversation these people have with him. And he entertains it, you know, like. I'm telling you, when you be with him, he was an ocean of love and compassion. That's all you can say, you know. Even though people, when you used to hear him from a platform, when he spoke about Vedanta, you are that. Don't remain as a fool. Don't be a body. You are that Paramatma. Don't live like a worm. Know that you are God. People are actually saying such wonderful things about them. You get so frightened, you know. And here this woman is saying that, you know, Swamiji, it'll be so nice if you can shave. He said, and then he said, no, don't you touch my beard. She said, Swamiji, one day I'm going to do like that. I'm going to come with a trimmer and I'm going to shave your beard. I really want to see what lies behind the beard. He said, haven't I told you? Never trust a bearded fellow, because obviously he's hiding something. So Swamiji, what are you hiding? You must be having, we saw your beard, even now you, and even then you could see. As I told you in the first day, that Mahatma who was telling, he says, even at 70, when you see his form, you see the glow of his skin. He looked like a teenager. That Mahatma was telling me. That is only much later now, you know. So she's like, okay, your skin is, you'll be looking so nice. She said, no, no, no. She said, but why? They don't ask, why? He said, because I'm covering my chin. So she says, why? He says, you know, when I was playing cricket, he used to play a lot of sports. A season ball hit my chin and my chin got smashed. And therefore, I've got a broken chin. Broken jaw, basically, you know. That's why I'm covering. And what does Hanuman mean? One who's Hanu, chin. Yeah. I've given one definition of Hanuman, whose chin, when he fell down from, when he was hit by the thunderbolt, so hit by the season ball, His chin broke. One means, chin means, no? Ego. Ego gone is Hanuman, no? Ego gone is the realized master. He says, my chin is broken. Therefore, Chinmaya means Hanuman. Now, I don't know whether you like it, but that's my interpretation of it. It's not Shastric, but he said that I'm the link between you. And who else other than Tulsidas ji knows that? Ram duare tum rakhware hot na aagya binu paisare sab sukh layahi tumari sharana tum rakshak kahu ko darna. If the Guru is not there to show us the Lord, how can we even enter into the gates? Therefore, Chinmaya. Hanumanji is that connection between you and the Lord. Guru is the connection between you and the Lord. And cannot be different from the Lord because he is making you one with the Lord. So that is the meaning of Chinmaya.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.